Hello and welcome to Docplexus News. In the recent turn of events, the doctors in Kolkata went on strike when a resident doctor was brutally assaulted by the patient's family. To act against such brutality and violence, Docplexus initiated hashtag Justice for Doctors Drive, where one comment posted by community members is equal to one vote against violence. Since its launch, till date, more than 3,000 doctors have joined us in the fight to end violence against doctors. Show your support by commenting below. In the recent turn of events, the state of Bihar has been another scanner with a potential outbreak of acute encephalitis. The deadly disease has accounted for more than 80 deaths so far. Furthermore, approximately 15 patients have been found to be critical, while many patients are kept under observation in city hospitals. The Health Ministry is supporting the state by providing treatment facilities for curtailing the outbreak. In the upcoming session of Lok Sabha, the Union Health Ministry would reintroduce the National Medical Commission Bill with major reforms in the education sector. Earlier in 2018, the bill was omitted due to the contentious provision of bridge course for medical practitioners. The reframed bill with suggested amendments has been reintroduced along with the additional proposal which allows the current Board of Governors, MCI, to continue. With the intention to boost manpower in the health sector, the Health Ministry has planned to transform 75 district hospitals into medical colleges. The initiative would be the part of the third phase of Human Resource for Health and Medical Education, where 58 district hospitals have been converted into medical colleges in the first phase and 24 in the second phase. Additionally, the initiative aims to elevate the services in the district-run hospitals. The US FDA has recently approved polatuzumab vedotin in combination with bendamustine and rituximab for the treatment of adult patients with relapsed or refractory diffuse large B-cell lymphoma. This novel antibody drug conjugate is targeted to those patients who have had at least two prior failed therapies. The approval of this chemoimmunotherapy is based on the positive results from a clinical trial in which cancer was not detected in 40% of the patients in the intervention group as compared to 18% of the patients in the comparator group. The US FDA has recently approved an auto-injector and a pre-filled safety syringe for the administration of mepolizumab in patients with severe eosinophilic asthma. The approval is based on the positive results from two clinical trials that demonstrated similar pharmacokinetic and pharmacodynamic results as compared to the previously approved lyophilized formulation of the same drug. Following approval, this drug becomes the first respiratory biologic to be self-administered by the patients in the home setting. The Indian Medical Association is amalgamating with Devi Ahilya Vishwavidyalaya and Deen Dayal Upadhyay Kaushal Kendra, wherein doctors would be taking courses in programming and finance. The computer training would help doctors to design their own website and further assist in thesis writing. On the other hand, doctors will organize seminars, workshops, and medical training programs for colleges without any charges. The National AIDS Control Organization has reported that around 1,342 people from India have been infected with HIV due to blood transfusion in 2018-19. Based on the data collected from integrated testing and counseling centers, Uttar Pradesh is found to have the highest number of cases, followed by West Bengal, Delhi and Maharashtra. Furthermore, it has been found that the negligence and shortcomings in donor screening and efficiency in testing are the major reasons for the high incidence. These were the latest happenings in the medical field brought to you by Docplexus, one of the largest online communities of doctors. Stay tuned for more every Thursday at 6 p.m. Happy Docplexus!